Well, you can just turn up the... Oh, I guess you can't turn up the...
I can just...
Well, I turned up a little bit. Yeah, it was my fault. It was... This wasn't... For some reason, it hit refresh and went back to the...
So is it going to be live on the Earmeal page?
Yeah, they just go to LA Art Stream.
LA Art Stream.
.com. Like, yeah.
Okay. I should post it on my Facebook. Or maybe I shouldn't.
This is how confident you are.
Oh, we have 3 minutes?
Yes.
So maybe not. Are we good with the sound?
Yes.
Oh, we are.
So it's going.
This is my project, Six String Sonics, and what it is the deconstruction of the standardized six-string guitar. What you're seeing is live footage from when I did a show in Tokyo. That's me. And this big structure holds nine different people. The people sitting on the outside are playing the one-string guitars. You can see that they're playing these little sticks, and those are the one-string guitars. The person in the center, at the bottom, is a percussion player, and there are two people on top, in the middle, who are playing an 8-foot bass. It takes two people to play that bass. One of them holds the strings, and the other person plucks them. So even the task of playing the bass is distributed amongst two people. But you can hear that the sound is a lot more freeform, and the chords you can never reach on a standard guitar. And basically I wanted to show people that by latching onto a 500-year-old design of an instrument, you're actually limiting your creativity. And by freeing your mind of the design and redesigning the instrument, you can actually broaden your compositional creativity. You can hear that these riffs and melodies you can never play on a standard guitar. This at a number of venues in Japan and also at the Fringe Festival in New York City. Another deconstruction project was the Unsound Interactive Concert that I did in Japan several times. And what it was the deconstruction of a VJ DJ event. Usually, if you go to a DJ event, you'll listen to one DJ's sound, and there's predetermined VJ that's making video to that music. But I thought it should be a much more of a creative process for the viewer or the concert goer. And what I did was I had four DJs play music to the same beat. So I'm going to be playing some video off of some documentation that was played on TV. So there's some Japanese narrations in it, but you can hear that this kick drum was the only thing audible in the venue. And there were four DJs that were making sounds to that beat. So at this event I had Kenny C, Captain Funk, Fantastic Blast Machine, and then the fourth audio stream I was mixing everyone's sounds. So you had four audio streams that were synced to that beat that you were hearing. And everybody in the audience had headphone radios. And they're able to tune in to their favorite DJ. So for example, if they tuned into Fantastic Plastic Machine, it's going to sound like this. Kind of housey. Or if you tuned into Captain Funk, a bit more glitch house. and it sounds totally different, but everyone's synced to that same beat. And there's also four VJs that are making video, and they're being projected onto four different screens. So the concert goer is able to choose their favorite audio and find their favorite audio-visual synergy by watching their favorite video. Another deconstruction project was the deconstruction of the band. This was a project from 1995 where the internet still had only very basic sites like newspaper sites. We only had the San Jose Mercury News and maybe the Washington Times. There were a couple bank sites up. But back then, I was surfing the net for interesting music, and I found this artist online, and I really liked his music, and I wanted to form a band with him, so I emailed the README file, and I found out that it was this teenager living in Perth, Australia. So I thought it might be a bit too far for me. I was in Tokyo at the time. But internet technologies were budding, so we tried sending each other files and remixing each other's work. And then we got signed to Universal in Japan. And I'll show you the music video. So you'll see that since we weren't really able to meet to make a music video, we had to create digital avatars of ourselves. And the CGI was created by another artist from Tokyo. Actually, eventually got signed with Toyota to do a couple of commercial music for them, and we did about 14 of them over 3 years. So, and even to this date, I still have never met this other guy in Perth, Australia. And what happened then was another net collaboration with an animator from Holland called Han Hoogerbrugge, who really liked our music, and we decided to create a deconstructed music video where the user can come in and fiddle with both the music and visuals. So since this is this ear meal broadcast isn't interactive. You're watching this in non-interactive form, but on the net, it's a flash animation that you can actually use your mouse and interact with the music video. And this won an award at the Japanese Media Art Festival as well as Ars Electronica. And Ars Electronica invited us to create an installation. And what we did was create a elevator installation where you can actually go into an elevator and watch this projected onto the elevator shafts walls. This is really bad documentation, but you can see what it looked like. And using the elevator's buttons, you can actually interact with the projected piece. That was in Linz, Austria. And now I'm going to go on to my decompositions pieces. These are sound art pieces that are about magnifying the experience of sound. So this first one is called Composition 2040. And it's a ping pong table that's been mic'd up. The game of ping pong was always a very rhythmic game. And I've got effectors that are amplifying this, the musical quality of the game. And this was actually selected to be shown at a museum in Poland just 2 years ago. Another project is called Tracts. This one is an interactive piece where you can blow air into a piece of pig's intestine. So inside this tube is a pig's intestine. You can kind of see this stringy thing inside. And there's a mic at the very end, so you can hear what you sound like through this organic resonator. And there's some effects that enhance the sound. It's kind of a rebellion towards the notion that art has to be permanent and people buy art so that it's an investment. This was a piece that started to smell really bad after about a week and then lasted only maybe about 10 days. Another piece is called Slinky Piece. I did this several times. The documentation here is from the Hammer Museum, and it's a ladder that's been mic'd up, and I have performers drop 100 slinkies down the ladder. So it's a generative audio piece. The sculptor is actually creating music on the fly. And also a generative sculpture as well. In the end, you're going to find a carnage of slinkies at the very bottom, and that gets displayed at the museum. And of course, I put effects on the sounds in real time. I displayed this piece at a sound walk in Long Beach, and that's kind of where Alan and I met. Another one is Pogophonic. It's a pogo stick that I've jimmied and turned it into an instrument, so jumping on it will create sounds. Brought in some professional pogo stickers. The guy in the brown is actually a Guinness's World Book of Records holder, and he's the highest. He can jump the highest on a pogo stick, and I brought him and his team in to use the pogo stick and create a composition out of it. But this guy can jump like 7 feet or something like that. This is a performance piece that I've collaborated with GX Jupiter Larson from The Haters. It's called Aerosol. And what we are doing is we're amplifying an aerosol can. And we have a camera in front of the aerosol can, and we are projecting the image behind us. So again, it's a generative audio piece as well as a generative video art piece. And basically we play until the aerosol can runs out of air. So even the artists don't even know when it's going to end. And at the very end, we bring out a CO2 fire extinguisher and we freeze the water on the acrylic in front of the aerosol can. And that's how it ends. I'll show you some video pieces that I've been working on. And there are experiments in mixing dynamic media with static media. For example, this one, I turned a storefront into a big ant farm. And the sounds you're hearing are actually amplified ant sounds that I recorded in a nano lab. You can see that the black areas are all painted, so that's the static portion, and then the moving images are the dynamic media. On the side there is, you can actually see the tunnels that the ant farm has. Called Haze. This one I've done at several museums in Japan, the US, Poland, and in China. But it's an installation about chaos theory. And I'm projecting images of chaos, but everything is reflected in the middle. So you find patterns arise out of the chaos. And in a sense, the viewer is becoming the chaos theorist because they're able to find the order inside of chaos. So it's kind of a passive interactivity. You can actually choose to find the order inside of the chaos, or you can just enjoy it as a non-interactive piece. And I did a version of this for the Glow Festival where I created a kinetic screen out of CO2 gas. So this is on the Santa Monica Pier. I've got CO2 gas being cooled and hugging the stairs, coming down the stairs, and then I'm projecting onto the fog. So the wind and the climate will change the way that the projection looks at any given moment. And of course, in the beginning, right after sunset, it was very difficult because there's a lot of turbulent air and it was carrying the CO2 away and you couldn't really see any of the projections. But later in the evening, about maybe 10, 11, it started to look really nice. Unfortunately, most of the Glow visitors had died down by then, but that's the nature of chance-based art. I also did this in a gallery where I had a stairwell projection. And I projected, again, imagery of gas, and I made it look like the gas is coming down the stairs, but it's all projections for this. You've got the illusion of being pulled back into the installation space. I did try to use a fog machine to actually do this. What I did at the Glow Festival, but it triggered a bunch of fire alarms in the building, and we had to evacuate about 1,000 people. I got in a lot of trouble for that. couple of sculptures. These are the guitar morphology series. This is pregnancy. The one on the left is impotence. Middle one, pregnancy at 3 months. The one next to the blue one is anorexia. And to the right is a fossilized guitar. So that's the kind of artwork that I do. And I'm now going to do a small demonstration of a sound performance that I've been performing a lot in Europe. This will be my second time in LA. It's called Radiologic. And what I have is about a half dozen radios hooked up to my computer, and I'll be making a live soundscape using these. The what's available on the airwaves in LA at this given moment. So let me get started with this, and I'll be faded out by the staff here at the end, so I'll say my goodbyes now.
The whole group, the whole family comes on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
It's a family event.
And you help with school on wheels till it ends, and then you come over and play in the gym.
Yes.
And wear out the kids so that their moms might get some rest.
Exactly.
Outstanding volunteers. We'll have to
remember that when it comes to honoring our volunteers. And we're going to share your story.
Thank you.
And what are your hopes? Daniel, you ready to share?
Thank you.
Al parque, a la playa, a las fiestas. Vamos a bailar un rico boleguito. Ay, me lo van a hacer de la otra. Amigos, si estamos pensando comprar un auto, van a la Carprosquía de Carson o Carprosquía de San Quinto Mix. Carprosquía es la agencia de esquina de mayor venta en todo California.
Por eso venden más barato.
¡Comprar un
carro! ¡Es una
combi! ¡Y comprar un Carprosquía, eh! ¡Mira,
Three.